before the days of flash memory video cameras, and before the days of hard drive video cameras, before DVD video cameras, and before magnetic tape video cameras, you had this. The acetate silver halide camera, also known as an old-fashioned movie camera. My father-in-law purchased this camera in January of 1960. Through the 60s and the 70s, he shot many, many rolls of film documenting his family quite well. Currently, I'm in possession of all of those rolls of film. It's film much like this. The white part is called the leader. Now it's strange to see my wife alive on film as a small child, bouncing around, interacting with grandparents and other family members who are no longer with us. It's stranger yet to see her growing throughout the years and finally ready to go off to college. It's such a treasure to have these films. I found this camera in one of the boxes of film some time ago when I agreed to transfer the many rolls of film into a digital format. The camera was even in its original Kodak box that you can see in the background. I thought I'd take a moment to show the camera to you. It doesn't use a battery, it has a winding mechanism. I guess there's a spring inside the camera. We wind this up, put plenty of tension on the spring. To load the film, you slide this latch to unlock the access panel. The normal position for this take-up spool would be down here on the bottom. The new film that you purchased at the drugstore or Kmart or wherever you bought the film back then, it would go on the top shaft, and you would thread the film up and through this part of the camera, known as the gate, I believe, and around the take-up spool. Now, while you had the access panel off, the camera has a film counter window right here. And at this point, you would turn this dial that's only accessible when the when this panel is off. But you would turn this dial. And I hope that's not too loud. But you turn it until you could see the letter L. And L stands for loaded. Next, you would put the panel back on. I must not have the spool all the way in. Latch it tight. And then you would run the camera until the letter L disappeared and you could see the number 25. The film came in 25 feet rolls, and when you could see the number 25, it meant that you were ready to shoot. You had 25 feet to create memories on. Now, before you began shooting, you still had to set the aperture so that the film would be properly exposed. And if you look in the lens opening, you'll see a small hole, and to set the aperture, let me readjust the focus. To set the aperture, there's a just a little plastic thumb wheel that you turn with your thumb, and there's a little dial with some lighting conditions listed: open shade, cloudy, bright, hazy sun, average, and snow and sand. And depending on the current lighting conditions at the time, you would turn this wheel. And when you did, you could see the little inside the lens opening, the aperture hole getting larger. Now, if it was real bright outside, it'd be a very small hole, so as not to overexpose the film. And if you were in the shade, you would turn the dial down to shade, and you can see that the hole is much larger. Now, if you were shooting inside, indoors, you would certainly need some very bright incandescent lighting. Let me adjust the focus one more time. Now, this is actually a cold shoe for mounting the lighting that you would use indoors, and it was generally very bulky lighting, and it had to be plugged into a electrical outlet in the wall. Now, before you began shooting, you want to make sure that you wound the camera one more time, because you know, you when you were positioning the film so that 25 would show up in the film counter window, you used up some of your spring. So now the camera was ready for you to burn through your meager 25 feet of film. Now, once you did that, you had to open the access panel again. Let's see if I can do this. And now the take-up spool was had all the film on it, and the store-bought original spool was empty. So you take the empty spool off and lay it aside. Take the take-up spool that came with the camera and you flip it and move it to the top position. Take your empty store-bought spool that the film came on and place it in the bottom position and re-thread the film through the gate and onto the empty reel. At that point, you would set your film counter again so that the L came into view in the little window, and put the panel back on. Go ahead and wind the camera again, obviously, and set the aperture. And you are now ready to expose the second side of the film. I say the second side because standard 8mm film is actually 16mm wide. On the first pass through the camera, you would expose one side of the film. And then you would do what I just demonstrated about flipping the reel and preparing the camera to expose the second side of the film. Now later on at the film processing lab, they would slice the film down the middle and splice it together, so now that your 25 feet is now turned into 50 feet of treasure. And it's this process is why original 8mm film was also known as a double 8 film. I'll hang on to this camera so that I can show future generations this strange device that their great-grandfather or maybe great-great-grandfather used to allow them to see their great-grandmother as a little girl. I appreciate you watching this, and look for an upcoming video from me of me actually running some of the film through a projector. If, and that's a big word, if I can make that type of film relaxing. So at this point, I'm going to adjust the microphone and run the camera.